I've loved the color pink since I was a little girl. Ever since I could dress myself, it was all I wanted to wear. And when I was 3, my mom had a pink party for me and made everyone we know wear pink. When quarantine started, I was feeling pretty down, and my mom gave me some weird advice. She said when she was feeling really down in college, she focused on her favorite color, green. So with nothing to lose, I started looking for pink everywhere. Before long, it was all I could see. It was in the walks I took with my best friend. It was in the clothes I picked out for myself in the morning. It was everywhere. It wasn't just the color pink anymore, though. It was a way of reframing my world. I had decided to look for something that made me happy. I called it my pink project, my quest to look for something happy or positive in every situation I encountered, something pink. Soon I wasn't just noticing pink, I was creating pink. I bought this face mask, I painted my nails pink. But you don't have to create positivity alone. I needed some help. So I went to Home Depot with my brother and his girlfriend, I bought this plant, I bought some pink paint for my room. I still haven't painted my room, but hey, it's a thought that counts. Time for the last step in my pink transformation. My brother's girlfriend, Brooke, agreed to help me dye my hair pink. I told my brother Miles I wouldn't leave him out of this video, as he did get all these, as he called them, sick angles. My transformation was complete. My hair was pink, my grandma was horrified, and I actually felt a lot better about my outlook on life. Who said rose-colored glasses are so bad? My advice to you is this. Find your pink, whatever that may be. Cover your life in it, cover your walls in it, get your friends involved. Just whatever you can do to make your life a little better for yourself. Hey, don't write yourself off yet.